Yeah, well, I'm Brian Burke, the editor of the Music and Sound Retailer, and with Donovan Bankhead, the owner of Springfield Music. Donovan, tell me about, we're going to talk about Believe in Music Week. First, do you think it's, is there any different philosophy you have? I'm really fascinated. It's a virtual show. You've never dealt with that before. Nobody has dealt with that before with NAMM. How are you being approached by manufacturers for meetings, and how are you going to handle it differently, if you are going to handle it differently? Is there any different approach you have?
Well, I mean, certainly our approach is different because, you know, in the past, it's, you know, a big endeavor, a big lift to get your team out to California and all the expense and whatever limits the people that you can take. So with this, it's going to allow you to try it to do it differently, which is what we're going to do. We're going to try to accomplish some of the same things we've done in the past, like meeting with our vendors. We've been getting regular emails from vendors asking for virtual appointments. So I'm very curious to see how they're going to handle that. Because historically, you know, I think about like when we would meet with our vendors, like, you know, Fender or Taylor, or really any vendor, they walk you through the booth and they, here's what's new. And there's maybe some artist demos, or, you know, you're just getting a touch, feel, hear, see all the stuff. And then you go back to their meeting area and discuss orders and so on and so forth. That's why I'm curious how they're going to handle that, if it's going to be the same way, or if they're going to set up a Zoom thing like this and the rep's going to sit there with the PDF or something and try to show it to you that way. So I'm really eager to see how they handle that. I bet each company is going to do it different. I bet there's going to be some companies that are going to really think through that and come up with a compelling demonstration virtually. And I bet there'll be other companies that are going to be like holding up their binder and pointing to products. So, you know, I think we'll just kind of see how they go. I think the other plus, of course, is, you know, we can now invite more of our store and company personnel to attend these things. There's more people that can participate in this stuff than what they could have before. One thing I did think was a little odd is the name of it to me sounds, I don't know that, I think they've had themes in the past, but it's always been the NAMM show and then whatever like their little buzzword or catchphrase was. And the Believe in Music Week, when I first saw it, it didn't register to me that it was a virtual NAMM show. Yeah. And I felt like it was, that may just be me. I haven't heard anyone else say this, so it may just be that I'm not very perceptive or whatever, but it took me a while. And actually I was involved in like a Zoom call with some of the folks from NAMM, and they were kind of explaining how this was going to work before it dawned on me. They're like, oh, this is like the virtual trade show. I kind of wish they would have just said that. I think that would have been a little clearer about like what, you know, what the intent is for dealer participation. It's not just a bunch of feel good stuff and concerts and things like that. I mean, there are those things, but my understanding is it's going to be a virtualization of the show. And that's going to be neat to see how they pull that off. Knowing NAMM, I think it's going to be done really well. I mean, those guys know what they're doing. They've had a year to prepare for this. I just think they're likely going to do a really good job. I have a lot of faith in the people that are doing that.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, I guess the negative is you can't see people in person.
Right.
Of course, but the positive, as you said, is that, well, there are a couple of positives. One, you don't have to make the expense to sending people there. There's also the positive that you could be at the store. I mean, you don't have to lose store time and you have more employees to be involved with it. So that's probably, you know, a good thing. There is a silver lining there that you could have more of your employees and you don't have to have them leave the store and have people fill in for them during that time, because you know, that's the one thing. The NAMM show is amazing, but the customer probably is not aware the NAMM show is going on. They're still going to walk in the store, right? So you got to have people there. So it's,
well, you know, I think another great example of that is you think about if you're a store that maybe you're a guitar shop and a band rental shop or a band shop as well. Like, and most of our stores, that's the way we are. day to day, we're doing a lot of guitar sales, but we also sell band instruments and step up instruments. But it's not as big a portion of a business as the guitar side is. And so if I was to take someone who's a band expert to the NAMM show, you know, they'd have a day or two maybe of meetings and things to see, but then the rest of it, they're just, you know, there's just not that much for them to do. Whereas now they could really concentrate that into the handful of meetings they need to see new products, to hear promotions for the year that are specifically related to them without having to incur the expense of being out in California for a week. Now, that being said, everyone loves being in California in January, and there's just nothing quite like being in person. You know, watching a concert on YouTube is not the same thing as being at the concert. And I think this is going to be a similar thing, but it's going to be something where it's far better than nothing. And for a lot of us, I know for me, I rely on the NAMM show to be that thing that gets me reinvigorated and re-excited. And I've become really dependent on the semi-annual cadence of how this works, you know, of getting, I'm charged up in January, I get charged up in June, and like, you know, and then with those things missing, I just, you know, it's hard to keep that motivation, enthusiasm high. And so I'm really grateful that they're attempting to do something like this. So.
Yeah, absolutely. The effort they're putting forth is no doubt unbelievable. And I'm sure they're going to make it as great event as they can. So, okay, great. I think that should be some good information, really great information for us. I guess lastly, I did want to ask you something that probably is not going to really change all that much that you probably could take advantage of. But, you know, I wanted to get your opinion on are the educational sessions. I mean, it's kind of similar, I would think. I mean, other than not getting the breakfast in the morning, not getting your sausage and juice and, you know, but in some bacon. Way, maybe it's
not getting the bacon. Oh, bacon, gosh. Right. I'm going to have to cook up a whole pound of bacon every morning.
So. Yeah, I guess you're going to have to have your stove ready every morning. but other than that, really, I mean, it's not really that big a deal, is it? I mean, you're kind of just sitting there watching someone talk when you're sitting on your computer watching someone talk. So I think that could probably be replicated pretty well. So are you going to take advantage of that in the educational sessions?
Without a doubt. And I completely agree with you, Brian. Like, I think that is the one piece that most easily translates over to this, because you can watch the presenter. You can even ask questions. I'm assuming they're going to have a way to be able to ask questions to the presenter and stuff. That's going to be the thing that's going to be most like where, you know, the normal NAMM show. And that idea center is the thing, like, without a doubt, I can say this unequivocally, with no hyperbole intended, Springfield Music would not be where we are today without the idea center. It's probably the single biggest thing that helped us to grow our business more than really anything else, right? More than me or even the people involved. Like, it's going there and getting inspired and educated and focused on the things we want to do has just been so critical for our business. And yeah, we always make that a centerpiece of our NAMM show. We don't schedule vendor appointments until we get the Idea Center schedule, and then we schedule vendor appointments around that. That's how we've done it for 20 years. And, you know, we're going to do it the same way this time, you know, and it's going to be easier to do this time than probably ever before, because we don't have to walk, you know, 20 minutes from Hall E all the way up to the fourth floor or whatever. We could just click and be at the next thing. So that part will be great.
I had not thought about that. That is really good. I thought about that I'm going to not make the appointments until the NAMM education sessions are out in schedule, but I didn't think about walking from one place to the other. That would really help. Right. That's a really good point. Thanks for that. Yeah. I know.
Save some time.
I guess I'm not going to get the 10 miles per day walking in, but you know,
that's true. Yeah.
But I will get, but then again, I probably would have been eating more bad food and drinking more alcohol if I had been there. So
without a doubt. Yeah. Without a doubt.
But all right, great. That's some great information. Thank you. Appreciate it, Donovan. Great stuff. And I hope you enjoy your experience there. You know, we will all see. We're all eager to find out what it's going to be like. So.
Yeah, I am too. I'm eager to see what this first one's like, and I'm hope it's the last one. But fingers crossed.
Well, I think so. But one thing I think they might do is they might have a virtual option in the future, though, so that you could have your other employees who can't go will still be able to enjoy that experience. And that would be a great addition to an AM show for people who can't
take it in person. Yeah, I agree.